Today on the show, we're taking a look at Funeral for a Friend Part 5, The Adventures of Superman, number 499, so stay tuned. Hey guys, welcome back to Comicgeddon TV, where all geek culture collides. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on future videos. Alright guys, as I said, today we're taking a look at Funeral for a Friend Part 5, The Adventures of Superman, number 499. This is what I would kind of call a filler issue. Not a whole lot goes on in this. Yeah, there's some action. You get scenes where Supergirl Matrix, for those of you who don't know, teams up with Dan Turpin. You get some gangbuster activity, but that's about it. We open up with Lex Luthor, beep, 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 he hears sound, and he goes to his computers. There's some activity going on in Superman, underneath Superman's tomb, so Matrix transforms into Supergirl and heads that way. An undercover police officer, spots something. She's moving so fast that all he sees is just something move. So he calls it in. Inside the tomb, she discovers that Superman's body is gone. Outside the tomb, we see Gangbuster thinking about how he and Cat Grant got into it. They were a couple, you know. And she discovered that he was out being Gangbuster again. That was one of the stipulations of them getting together, is that he couldn't be Gangbuster anymore because she didn't want him out risking his life and she didn't want to be worrying about him every night. So with the death of Superman, he became Gangbuster again, and they got into it. And then we come up on Ma and Pa Kent, Pa talking to Lois. Lex is in a very grumpy mood, and his personal assistant, whatever, comes. She tries to get down his pants, for lack of a better term, and he just tells her to go away. We get Dan Turpin and the task force showing up at the tomb. We get some actual Gangbuster fighting scenes. Matrix, Supergirl. For those of you who don't know, Matrix is a shapeshifter. She has all these amazing powers. She has some telepathy, some telekinesis, super strength, invulnerability, super speed, flight, shapeshifting ability, obviously, and just she's very overpowered. When she came to Earth, which I will be going over in another video, she took on the identity of Supergirl. This is the first post-crisis version of Supergirl. This is not Kara Zor-El. Dan Turpin goes in and he finds Supergirl is being attacked by Underworlders. He goes in to try and help. They attack him. He and Supergirl team up, but his clothes get ripped to shreds. There's an explosion. And we end with Supergirl bringing Dan Turpin out in pretty much his underwear. And Cadmus having Superman's body. Like I said, not really. There's a lot of action, don't get me wrong. But the only thing that really pushed the story forward was that Cadmus had Superman's body. And that was just a brief shot. Yeah, I don't know if... I don't really feel this is an essential issue. An essential part for Funeral for a Friend. But if you want the complete collection, pick this up. So there you go, guys. Funeral for a Friend Part 5, The Adventures of Superman, number 499. I'm Shannon with Comicgeddon TV, the only place on YouTube where all geek culture collides. If you're new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and a little notification bell so you don't miss out on future videos. Take care, my friends.